Hey guys, this is Gaijin Hunter, and this quick video is a request from a Japanese viewer who wanted me to help spread the word on why Lagercruz is not included in World or Iceborne. Much like the West, many people in Japan assume that it's a neck issue, but that isn't the case. It all started with the GDC 2018 talk, in which they showed an early prototype of Monster Hunter World, and at the end of it, Lagercruz popped up out of the ground. There, Tokuda tried to explain that they saw technical hurdles already on the horizon, and considering the amount of work it takes to add a skeleton and redo animations, it was just too risky, so decided not to include it. However, on the Monster Hunter Radio, which aired on October 28, 2019, Kaname went into much greater detail, and people obviously didn't listen to the podcast, and so this info has not become very widespread. In the podcast, Kaname explains that long necks and tails aren't the issue at all. It has to do with how much of the body is laying on the ground. For leviathans and snake wyverns, a good portion of their body lays flat to the ground, and because they have such minute changes in ground shape with this game, like slopes and bumps, it takes a tremendous amount of processing load to accurately calculate it so that the body stays correctly attached to the ground that it's moving on. Slopes in particular were mentioned by Kaname as being problematic. So they had to abandon it as they knew they would not be able to possibly do it without compromising the game. He even joked that the team that made the prototype Lagercruz and World had self-formed its own Team Lagercruz when Iceborne was being developed, and they took a second try at it, but they were unable to get it done. My take. Since they're dealing with a specific engine and more importantly, specific hardware with the consoles, they simply hit the barrier of what was possible given the constraints and power. That means that a next generation Monster Hunter game would most likely be able to process things much better, and as such, we should be able to look forward to Leviathans and Snake Wyverns in the future games. I do also find that there are three neat observations keeping all this in mind. 1. Look at the prototype and notice that Lagercruz never moves, it always stays in place. This is likely because the performance would have tanked if it moved. 2. Look at a longer monster like Kol'Tarath and you'll discover that the gold doesn't really move across the ground that well. It actually floats in the air or clips right into it. But that's okay because this is not part of its body. Plus the map is designed to be more flat, and as you break off parts of the longer body, the hunt gets more aggressive. And 3, because necks and tails aren't the issue, nor is collision, that's why we can see that Fatalis is returning. Of course it does have a special map, so I'm sure that helps in reducing the processing load as well. Anyways, I hope this sheds light on the subject, and if anything, you should be excited knowing that in the future, a next generation Monster Hunter game should easily be able to overcome this processing load issues that were present on the current gen machines. The reason Lagercruz isn't included is not a neck issue, but a ground issue. Hope you guys enjoyed this quick video, and until next time, happy hunting.